Wow, everybody, what is going on, everybody, and welcome back, CronosCrypto.com fam. There's a lot going on right now, and I mean, since yesterday with a nice pump, we ended the live, I made the video late yesterday, and we went even higher at 1 a.m., of course, right now, retracing back. I see Crypto.com Twitter, Chris, now announcing a partnership with a company that needs no introduction, and actually, yours truly interned back in 2016. I'm going to tell you everything. I mean, even in all the good news and what we're going through right now, we see FUD, according to some FUDsters, right, on Twitter. They say that Crypto.com is the next one to go bankrupt. Are you kidding me? My response and everything, by the end of this video. Don't forget to smash the like button, everybody, and consider subscribing to the channel. Turn on those notification bells. Welcome back, everybody. It's a brand new week with a lot of challenges ahead. We're still at 6 cents, 7 cents on the price of CRO. Are you adding more? Are you selling more? It's up to you. It's your money. But as always, I'm looking at $1, nothing less. On a piece of magic, the boss, Crypto.com CEO, Chris, says, and what's happening? Well, boom. But starting the hottest FIFA World Cup memorabilia ever, Crypto.com introducing Coca-Cola Piece of Magic NFT collection. And if you are not that into NFT, it's totally fine. This, to me, represents more partnerships. Remember, is Coca-Cola a what of the FIFA World Cup 2022? It's a partner. What is Crypto.com? A sponsor. So if in the long term we want more crypto exchanges involved in these massive events, then Crypto.com is doing a good thing, right? Whether you are for NFTs or not, I just like this because it opens new doors, it opens more adoption, it opens the, I mean, people are going to be saying, okay, Coca-Cola and Crypto.com, why are the two of them together, right? Remember, we're preaching to the masses, to the next billion users, and I think this is really good. Now we come here, teams up with Crypto.com and an artist, 10,000 NFTs. Now, NFT recommendations and strategies, you know Web3 is down, you know NFTs are risky, you know NFTs can vary, vary many, many times, and it doesn't mean that it has the Crypto.com or Coca-Cola, I will say, emblem and brand that's going to be worth $10,000 or so, right? But it is the NFT world, and it's never bad, you know, if you like this, to go ahead and check it out. 10,000, of course, but I'm happy. I'm really, really happy that this is happening. So about the FIFA World Cup, guys, let's go back to this in just a second. Right now, what I think is also very important to note, on the Crypto.com hashtag, take a look at this. You can now bet on the next exchange to file for bankruptcy on Vegas odds. So we're coming from good news on Crypto.com about sponsorships, about this, to bankruptcy. What's happening now? According to Vegas, the most likely one to go bankrupt is Crypto.com. What do you think? I'm just saying, no, man. I mean, really, absolutely. I mean, this is the page. This is the page. Crypto predictions, VegasOdds.com. Now, is this reputable? I don't think so. Obviously, they have no idea what they're talking about, and just trying to create FUD at the end of the day. Somebody is behind this movement of bashing and trashing on CRO. That's it. I mean, you guys told me in the comments last time we spoke about this account bashing and just flooding a lot of the Crypto.com users, right? My opinion, I don't care what they say. A lot of you responded correctly. It kind of makes you buy more CRO at the end of the day because they make it much lower. These are the type of posts. I don't think they actually do this, but you see the sell-off. I need to update my price now. We went to 15% since yesterday. It was just yesterday, on December the 4th, right here. Starting the day, December 4th, all the way in one day, 15%. Now we had to come back to a nice 6%. I know it is what it is. It is what we see in the bear market, you see? But it's good that there's people on whales buying CRO and giving us these nice breaks, because it's been a while since November 20th or the 15th that we haven't seen the price of, boom, 7 cents. So imagine for some reason, people just don't want crypto.com to let go. They want to keep bashing and thrashing. And every single time I come and I found for the crypto.com hashtag, this account has something negative about Crow. It is what it is, man. And of course, letting people know about the NFT news. One thing as well is Crow is losing right now. Wait, Oscar, what do you mean? Yes, we're losing. Croatia. I mentioned that because someone actually made a reference to it. And I'm like, oh, that's so true. Croatia is losing against Japan right now. 0-1, right? So I'm just fun. But it is cool that the FIFA World Cup continues. And well, let's go Croatia. Wouldn't that be amazing? When it comes to the fear, everybody, it is what it is. Sad but true. There's not much going on right now when it comes that can bring it back to the greed. But staying up to date and looking at, you know, the big picture really helps, guys. Really, really helps. So obviously the FUD will continue. I completely disagree that crypto.com is going to be the next to go bankrupt and it's not going to go bankrupt. But just to give you an idea, the level of FUD and misinformation and scare, you know, all that danger zone that people are trying to paint right now, it's insane. With the good news that we're having right now, I mean, with partnership with Coca-Cola, I mean, I was an intern back then in Atlanta, Georgia. It was amazing, man. With Coke, what a beautiful company that everybody knows. And obviously, if it partners with crypto.com, that means something, in my opinion. Could have been Binance, could have been Coinbase, could have been Gemini. They selected crypto.com. And as someone who worked there for a while at Coca-Cola, these are high-level professionals. I'm happy they selected well, right? Now, let's go to the price, everybody, and take a look at what happened, right? Obviously, yesterday, we were in the live, and we saw this live, these pumps. Then I stopped the live somewhere here, kept going, and then some retracements kept going. So we're seeing a nice 15% right here. So from the 15 minutes, I need to go to the 4 hours to show you, and I'm going to clear this to see. Look at this. This price matches this, which is November 15th. So exactly about 2+ weeks that we haven't seen this price. Sadly, it's by pump like this and dump, but at least it gives the opportunity for some users to cash out at the top levels, knowing that we are in a bear market. The updates and the news, man, it is what it is, right? Obviously, the last times that we have gone down has been by dump, so, and then a massive pump too. So this kind of like repeated, but inversely. I'm happy this is happening, and this could be just the beginning, because look at this. The beginning of November, we were at way above 10 cents, and it's trying to break. It's trying to get out, and it's trying to let the world know that Crow is going to the moon. Thank you very much for watching, everybody. Here's the update. Pretty excited. Remember, three things. We're still waiting on the crypto audit. We're still waiting on Genesis to be solvent. And we're still waiting on less increases in the hike rate for the federal funds rate from Papa Powell. All of those, if they come positive, fly all the way to the sky. I'll see you next time, everybody. Like and subscribe. Peace.